Now I'm like, shorty, what you doing, what you call for? She sees that freeze on my neck, that's what she'll fall for. She said I'm always on her mind, I should get off more. Said I can work a 9 to 5 and still get off tour. Now I'm like, shorty, what you doing, what you call for?
What is up, family? Man, I know I've been away for mad long, and I truly apologize for that. Just been real, real busy. So with that being said, I had to come with some straight fire for y'all, man. So not too long ago, I dropped a video, transformation from braids to curls, and I also did a bald fade. And after I posted the video, I just surfed the comments and took as many comments as I possibly could and tried to cater to all them in the form of one video. So in this video, I'll be giving you a step-to-step guide to the haircut I'm doing today and also giving you a more budget-friendly curl routine, because in the last video, every single product I had was $50 plus. So there was a lot of people asking me if there was any affordable substitutes for the products I was using, so I'm going to cover that real soon. But anyways, I feel like I'm talking too much, bro. Let's get into the haircut, man. So the clippers I'm using today are the Wall Seniors. The trimmers I will be using is the Andes GTXs. And let's get into the guards. The guards I will be using is the 1/16th, aka the half guard, the 1/8th guard, aka the one guard, the 3/16th guard, which you cannot see right here, which is the 1/2 guard. And finally, I will be using a 1/4 guard, which is Wall's number 2 guard. And just to let y'all know, I've been woofing for a good month just to get y'all this video. So y'all better run them likes up, you feel me? But anyways, you just wanna brush your hair consistently until all of your hair lays down, in which mine is having trouble because I haven't brushed it in like 2 weeks. Oh my God. So here I'ma start with the 1/4 guard, Wall's number 2 guard, lever closed, just so I could cut all my hair down even. So finally, after that, what you want to do is open your lever and you just want to start to create that initial guideline like so. So what I do after that, I grab my 1/8 guard with the lever open and I begin to make one more guideline about a good inch above the initial guideline I made. You want to take your 1/16th guard with the lever closed just so you could begin to blend out that first initial guideline that you made. And this step is a lot easier than it looks. All we're gonna do is switch between closed lever to open lever to about halfway, but I'm actually give y'all a step-by-step process in just a little bit.
Like I said,
said earlier, you just want to start with the lever closed and you just want to go slightly higher than that first guideline. Then you want to open your lever about halfway and then you go a little higher than that one. And then after that, you just open your lever all the way up and just do what you want to do. You know what I mean? Go as high as you want to go. Just don't go over that second guideline. You feel me? And then after that, you just look at your blend and you just switch back and forth from open, halfway to close and just knock out all the dark spots. Now you want to grab your 3/16th guard with the lever open and you just want to try to knock down a little bit of that bulk. Now right here, you're gonna put back on your 1/8 guard and switch between open to close lever just so you can clean it up a bit. With the lining brake, you just pick up your trimmers and get it as crispy as possible. course, gotta clean up the eyebrows a little bit, boy. You feel me? Can't be out here looking like a werewolf. You do that, you practically straight, you feel me? For my mustache, the gel I will be using is Elegant Shave Gel Plus, you feel me? After that, bro, we done with the haircut, you feel me? Ooh, look at that boy, that boy looking good, don't he? Ooh. But for the most part, this is the haircut, y'all. Looking at it, I see a few more areas that I possibly could have attacked better. But I don't care, it's still saucy. But anyways, I'm about to get into the hair routine, y'all. Look at your boy look like he just got electrocuted, dog. For the shampoo and conditioner, I just ran to Walmart and just picked up anything, the Argan Oil Mucurucurucu shampoo and conditioner, which is the more expensive one, but you can always go a little cheaper. But I'ma be right back after I get out the shower, dog. So this is my hair fresh out the shower after shampooed and conditioned. So the curling products I will be using today is the My DNA Defining Custard, the My DNA Leave-In Conditioner, and of course I had to add this one. It's the Diva Curl Be Leave-In Conditioner. And the only reason I added this product is for the finish, like it has a nice hole and a nice shine, and that's what my hair needs. And which this product is more on the pricier side, but you can pick it up on Amazon for about $14. As opposed to my last video, the products I used, I got a shampoo, conditioner, and a leave-in conditioner for about $150. With these, you could get the conditioner and shampoo for $10 each. So about right now, I'ma just add a light layer of the Defining Custard, and then you're gonna see me brush it out just to get an even layer of that product. But you can get the Defining Custard for about $10. You get the My DNA Leave-In for about $7.50, and you can get the Diva Curl for about $14. So all together, it'll come out a little over $50. But let me remind you, the Diva Curl is not a necessity, nor is the shampoo and conditioner. You can always go a cheaper route with the shampoo and conditioner. That's up to you. But now that that is done, you just want to start spraying in your leave-in conditioner, and you just want to massage that through your hair. So for the most part, this is my hair with just those two products, which is pretty decent. So like I said, the Diva Curl is not a necessity, but watch, once I add the Diva Curl, is going to minimize that white look. Your boy looking good. Sure. But right after that, you just want to shake out your hair. You just want to give your curls some time to breathe. Get them some fresh air, bro. Just let them flow and let them be free. But nah, this is the look for the most part, bro. If you say those curls ain't popping, you just hating. But that's all right, though. I'ma just let y'all admire it a little more. dry, and then I'ma come right back and I'ma show y'all the final results. So what is up, gang, right? But as you can see, this is my hair after it's about 80% dry. But I know there's still gonna be a few people to comment that they still cannot afford these products. So by all means, please comment below and let me know if y'all want me to do an even more budget-friendly routine. But anyways, I want y'all to take a look at this before that. Y'all better subscribe to my channel, bro. Now I'm like, shorty, what you doing? What you call for? She sees that freeze on my neck, that's what she'll fall for. She said I'm always on her mind, I should get off more. Said I can work a 9 to 5 and still get off tour. Now I'm like, shorty, what you doing? What you call for?